Hello everyone, welcome back to yet another lecture on the resources. This is Kirti Sangule and we are dealing with some of the important resources. We had started with a major part of the resources and we have completed the forest resource, water resource as one of the major part for our study. You should always keep in mind, friends, that when we are going for something called as resources, as I've mentioned earlier also, that whenever you talk something about a resource, you should always have a first question in mind regarding what do you mean by that particular resource. So we had seen the similar concept with regards to forest resource also. When we see forest resource and when we are going to see something today with regards to land resource, you will find that you can much have a comparison with both of them. That means you can find much similarity in case of forest resource and land resources. But what we can do is we are finding out something with regards to a difference part. That means forest resource, we had seen something of importance, how the forest resources are there, how the forest resources are helping the human beings, and how the human being is deteriorating the forest resource. That was a main criteria for understanding one kind of resource. What we are going to look forward when we are talking something about a land resource is what exactly is the idea of land resource, what are the types of land resources, that means how many kinds of land resources are being categorized and what and how the human use these land resources will be one part. The next part we are going to see today is what are the type of land uses, that means how the human beings or how we especially, when we are talking something about India or Asian countries, how we are using these land resources, what is the consumption rate, what is the degradation rate, and is there any kind of ecologically important factor which can help to maintain these land resources? Because we know when we talk something about the resource, it should be always kept in mind that we are talking something about a deteriorating case. That means it is extending, it is getting limited, it is getting degenerated. So that is a deteriorating case. And we are going to look forward for a solution which is a different kind of solution. Because land resource, as I said, is comparatively similar to that of forest resource when talked about. The only difference which can be characterized on the basis of land and forest is when we talk about EFL, that means you cannot apply the EFL criteria of conservation for forest resource, but we can apply the criteria of EFL for the land resource. So that will be our major part for the study. So in this slide, you can see that land resources are something which can be categorized in five major parts. Now we know that we are living in Asian countries, not only in Asian countries, but wherever you go, in whichever continent you can study, you will find that these basic five criteria are running everywhere. There are hills, there are valleys, there are plains, river basins and wetlands. Now I know that it might be a question for you people that why to study or why are we mentioning these three or five criteria basically at the very start itself. Reason is because this is one of the finite kind of natural resource. That means human beings, even though can live at a plains, human being can live at a hilly area. But what we have done, we human beings have generated such a kind of technology that this technology makes the human even survive in the places like valleys, which are deep inside, or river basin areas, or even the wetland areas also. Henceforth, we have taken or included this part as the very first part. So now the second question should arise for you people is that what exactly is the land resource? That means why are we studying the land resources? So the answer should be very simple. Land resource is an available part of a land which is meant for exploitation. Okay? You should keep this word in mind very clearly, the word called as exploitation. If you do not mention this word called as exploitation, it means you are not studying a land resource. Reason is because we people have been using the land in all forms. For example, we are using it in agricultural form, we are using it non-agricultural form. So when we talk something about non-agricultural form, means we are building homes, we are creating bridges, we are using it for cultivating food, which is actually meant for the transportation purpose, that means for the export and import purposes. We are creating town halls, we are creating cities, commercial, etc., etc. That means we are exploiting it. Okay, so that means a land resource which is available, a small part of a land which is available and which is used by the human being for the exploitation purposes will be called as a land resource. Now, land resource is something which refers also to a land which is undergoing many changes. Many changes in a sense, that means it can be changing itself from a renewable form, because we know land resources are something which are renewable form. For example, you can have a gold, bauxite, coal, any kind of minerals which is there in the land, which is available for us in the land in a renewable form. But how is it changing itself? Land is converting itself into a non-renewable form because of the use of human. That means we are continuously using these renewable resources, these natural mineral resources, which is provided there itself by the nature to us in a natural form. It is used by the human in such a vast area or in such a vast condition that we are converting it into a non-renewable form. Second important thing, we are not only using the land resources, but rather we are creating toxicity and we are dumping it into a nuclear waste. That means whatever the industrial product is being produced for the human, for the growth of the human being, for the economic development of the human being, after that the remaining material, which is to be actually degraded material or which is a poisonous material, is directly dumped into a part of land where it will create a waste part which is toxic in nature. And this toxicity creates a complete hazard for the land, creating a complete resource to degenerate. That means you will not find a complete good kind of mineral in that part from the area of toxicity. Now, these material which are available to us are utilized at a very high cost. That means you are extracting out the material, for example, coal. We'll go with the coal so that it becomes easy for you people to understand. Or for that case, you can also go with the gold. So we are using it in a raw form. We are extracting it out in a raw form from the land, which is available for the free cost. But these free cost material for the economic development of the country are being then polished, reutilized and generated for the human environment in such a manner that you have to pay for it. That means we are using the land resource for a commercial use also. So land resource basically is used more in a commercial form. So you can go in commercial form from wide areas. That means you can also for that case, think about a water. The water which is available on the land resource, which is actually for free, is being cost. So that is the purpose of generation of economy. So like I said, that land resource by the environment is provided to us as a central position. Because if there is no land, human cannot survive. I've been saying these things again and again. If there is no water, if there is no forest, the human cannot survive. But think about it, you have water, you have forest areas, okay? And the forest areas are completely wild. But you do not have a land area where the human can live. That means a human society can live. It is impossible to survive over there. And for such conditions, it has been categorized. That means especially when looked forward from the point of view of India, we have been categorized, India has been categorized for having three major zones or segments of land resource. It goes with 43% for plains, 30% for mountain regions and 27% for plateau. Now, even though we have three major zones, these three major zones or segments are being divided into six major types of soil types. Now, why to study these six major types of soil types is the reason, because as I've said in the very first or starting part itself, that we people are not leaving a single part of a land to survive over there and to establish ourselves over there. So what do we do for surviving, for establishment of the human society, human existence? We are trying to convert this land resource or soil resource into an some different part. Now, what do I mean by it? Let's explain. We know that India is having six major types of soil. Now, these six major types of soil are alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, mountain soil, desert soil, and laterite soil. Okay. So, this six major kinds should be always there in your mind when you are studying something about these land resources. Now, what we people do, we have a very bad habit of hybridizing everything. For example, you can find a particular kind of a crop plant will only grow good in black soil, or for that case in mountain soil. Okay. But what we are doing, we are converting the product itself. That means we are creating a hybridized product. And when we are creating a hybridized product, what we are generating? We are generating such a kind of a seed which will try to develop itself in any other kind of atmosphere or soil proportion. That means a plant which was good enough to grow in black soil now will generate or grow itself in desert soil also, or maybe in mountain soil also, or maybe in laterite soil also. So that is the reason you have to always keep in mind that India is having six major kinds of soil condition, and these six major kind of soil condition help the human being surviving in India to flourish. So that is one of the major reason. Now let's understand how the land is being used. Okay, when we are talking something about the land is being used, this is just a brief. We'll go with the next slide, which will explain you the types of land uses. So just going with the brief, you have to keep in mind that we use the land in a form of a forest or agriculture or non-agricultural form. This is one of the basic kind which was there since ages together. We have been using land as one of the nature motherland for these basic purposes for getting the food. This was major part. But what development has done for the utilization is we have cultivated the land. That means we are creating the land itself. Now what do I mean by this? There are forest and there are agricultural land which are very different in their nature. Okay. So like I said, in the forest resources, if you go back and rewind up yourself, you will find that forest resources are degenerating, or we are causing deforestation for the purpose because we are cultivating agriculture over there. That means forest resources are being cut down, land resources is being created over there for the source of agriculture. So this is completely very opposite to the nature, because whatever the soil, in the early slide what we have seen, whatever the soil is being generated over there or flourished over there with the help of the minerals, these soil are natural in itself, and we are trying to change the nature. So we are creating or we are cultivating. So that is something, a biophysical property. Second biophysical property is something that means we are creating a wasteland. We are dumping the garbage, we are dumping all the toxic material in particular land area, and we are completely creating a hazard over in that particular land area, due to which the minerals are completely lost, and that is called as a wasteland area. Or else you can say that we are creating a miscellaneous land also. Now what do you mean by miscellaneous land? We'll see in the next part, but just keep in mind that we are using it as miscellaneous form. That means we are using it haphazardly. We are not having an exact idea how to use this particular land area, and it is being used haphazardly, widely. Okay. We are creating it in wilderness also. That means all the wild animals, you can find in the news channels right now, newspapers right now, that the wild animals are entering into the land areas of human existence. Right? Have you thought about it? Why is it taking place? A simple reason for this is that forest areas are being cut down and agriculture is being created over there. That means human existence have started over there in the forest area. Now think about it, that if you people or we people are going to start live in the forest area and create a human society over there, where will be the wild animals living? So that is called as wilderness. So that is one of the management and modification process what human has done. That means we have completely managed ecosystem according to our will and wish rather than maintaining according to the environment. We have modified it. Modified for the purpose of generating economy, generating cultivation, generating more amount of finance for that case. According to the study of United Nations Food and Agricultural Organization Water Development Division, which was done basically in the year around 1990s, they had found out and they had categorized the basic four parts which should be there in India. That means these parts, that these percentage are very different for each and every country. So this is mentioned for our country, that is India. So they mentioned that 13% land area should be in arable form, 26% should be a pasturage form, 1.5% for be in urban areas, and 32% should be a forest land and woodland areas. So if you remember the forest areas, you have gone through this kind of categorization earlier also. That means India was given, or India is being told, that around 32 to 33% should be a forest land area. And what we are doing it, we are reducing it. Rather now, if you see, you can find it is somewhat in between 10 to 20% only, which is not helpful or which is not that healthy for the human society of India. But it is not being considered right now also as serious part. The important land use is city planning. That means cities are being generated in very different kind. Now this different kind means we are generating residential areas, we are creating transportational areas, we are creating recreational areas, that is called as city planning. Now this city planning has to be limited, but we are not limiting ourselves. Rather we are going wide in that case when we take something for creation of city planning. Because human population is developing at a larger extent, we are developing or we are growing to such an extent that we need land or we need environment or we need places to live in. We are cultivating, we are utilizing the land which was not meant for human existence also. For that case, if you go, that means valleys. Valleys are not exactly meant for the human existence. Valleys are meant for the wildlife. But what we people are doing, you can find for that case the tribal zones are being created in the valleys only, and that is called as city planning. The need of the man has been such developed, that means it is widely developed, that we are modifying everything. We are not leaving a small space, nook and corner of a land for the utilization of a man, and that is not helpful in the future generations for the people like us. Now I said we'll go into the depth of type of understanding the land resources. Now what do you mean by understanding and type of land resources? So if you remember, I've said something about the word called as city planning. This city planning is highly definized into five different categorization. That means we people have created the five major land resources, use of land resources. And keep in mind, these land resources are very much useful for human being from the commercial point of view. Okay. First one is creation of residential land. Now, what do you mean by residential land creation? Wherever you live, that means it's your home, which is a single home built on a plot, or you can might be living in an apartment, or you might be living in a town hall, or and for that case, maybe a residential zone completely. In short, wherever human beings live is called as a residential land area. This land area provides housing to the people to live in. As a mean of source of housing, what we do, we try to earn commerce from that part. Okay, because we pay taxes. Now what I meant earlier also, the part which was free, the part which is free is being now charged. So one more reason for this charging is because human population is growing. We are trying to capture each and every part, and just to restrict this part of capturing, we are being charged. So that is called as residential lands. Second one, that is agricultural land. So we know that agricultural land is completely meant for the food production. Okay. Now this can be something related to crop production, maybe fruit production also. But also you should keep in mind when we talk something about with regards to land resource and with especially regards to agricultural land resource, it is not only growing up of vegetables, fruits or crop plants for that case, it is also means of development and growth of products such as meat, egg, poultry, that means which can give you a good resource or good source of money will be called as a land resource. So it can include fruits, vegetation, even for that case some decorative material, for that case some medicinal plant also, meat, that means whatever the poultry products are there, whatever eggs are being we are getting or poultry products are getting, or for that case even milk products, whatever we are getting is actually called as an agricultural land area. The third one, that is called as recreational land areas. Now you people might be enjoying or relaxing. So when you are thinking about something like enjoying or relaxing, the first thing which comes to our mind is called as hiking, right? So you go for hiking or you go for swimming or climbing, etc., etc. And that is called as recreational land areas. That means a particular land area is taken and it is being generated for the fun and development of the people, where the people can come, relax themselves, play a lot, get enjoyed, relax, and then again move away. So it is not an area where you can stay. It is an area you have to stay partially. Of course, you have to pay for it. After you take advantage of this area, that particular atmosphere, that particular nature, you at some times move away. So that is called as a recreational area. So for keeping in mind of recreational area, you can keep in mind the creation of swimming pools, or for that case, hiking in on the mountains or climbing a tree also can be a recreational area. So forest land areas are being such examples which are taken in for the recreational land areas. The fourth one, that is called as transportation. Now transportation, everyone knows that we are building up roads, we are building up highways, railways, airlines, subways, tunnels, etc., etc. So that is called as transportation area. So one very good example of transportation area which you can find, you can just see the highways which have been created on the Indian zones. So we have created, we have cut down the forest for that some cases, and we have created tunnels, right? Also we have some, at some parts we have built holes and blocks, huge blocks in mountain ranges also, and we have created tunnels. Now this is being done for one major source because we have to bypass the road. That means we have to cut down the distance from a larger part to a smaller part. So that is one more reason for creating a transportation land areas. And transportation land areas are also one of the experienced part of land resource which gives you much economy. So because we are connecting, reason is we are connecting from one country to another country also. So that is one of the major resource which is being developed by each and every country and which are everyone look forward. The fifth and the most important land resource is commercial land resource. Now you might be feeling that this all four gives something called as economy. So why to study something about the commercial land resource? Actually, when we talk about commercial land resource, we can find it much similar to the recreational land resource, but it is different. In recreational land resource, an area is being created where you can relax. Okay, you have to pay a small amount and you can relax. Fine. Commercial land areas means you have to pay a lot of money to stay over there, to enjoy over there. For example, you can go for complexes or you can go for malls. So no one will let you have anything over there for the free of cost. It's impossible that anyone can give you something free for them. So that is called as commercial land resources. That means office complexes, but you can find on the highways. You can really find a good amount of commercial land areas to be developed on the highways. When you go from any highway all over the India, you can find office complexes are there, shopping malls are there. For that case, service stations are there, restaurants are there. That means they are completely profit-based business areas. So developers take a land, they develop the land, they give on a lease or they give on, for that case, rent, and then they earn money from it. So that is called as a commercial land area. Now, when we have studied all these type of land resources, one point which comes in our mind is that we are doing these things for earning money. So commerce is one of the major part which has led us to develop all these five kind of land resources. But also should come one point, that is, are we using only the land for the commerce purposes and we are degenerating it? The answer is yes. Because we are using the natural resource for our purpose rather than looking forward that it should be regenerated. That means we are cutting down the forest and creating deforestation, correct? Or we are letting our domestic animals, for example, sheep, cow, where they can graze, they can have a good kind of fodder. That is only the forest areas, jungle areas. So we are letting them into the forest area so that they can graze. Now you might be thinking, so what is the bad in it? Actually it is bad. Reason is because, as I said, each and every animal, each and every ecosystem is being divided accordingly by the nature. So if you enter into the wild zone, how would you expect that the wild animal will not enter into your zone? So our domestication is entering into the wild areas for grazing purposes, for financial purposes, then itself you will get a return back that the wild animals are entering into your domestic zones. That is called as overgrazing. One of the major problems what we people are doing with the land is faulty agriculture. It is being already decided, nature already decides that if you take one kind of a crop at one particular season, the same crop should not be taken at the second time, because minerals should be restored. You should take, you should give time for the land also so that it can restore the minerals. But what we people are doing, we are taking a single crop again and again, again and again, and due to which the complete mineral present in the land is being utilized. It is getting deteriorated, and finally a point comes when you find that there is no mineral, there is no organic matter over there. Now what we do when we find there is no mineral, no organic matter, we start putting on the fertilizers, insecticides, pesticides, etc., etc., because of which again the land is getting spoiled. So we are creating in turn pollutant also. We are dumping the material, we are creating pollutant. We are mining, we are creating pollutant. We are entering into the forest and we are dumping over there human society, we are creating pollutant. So in turn we are creating something which is an induced form into a natural form. Okay, this can be a natural process also. That means land degradation can be a natural process. For example, we have seen acid rain. So even though I do agree with the point that acid rain is one of the major factor of human utilization, human pollutant which human has created, for example sulfurs and nitrogen oxides which are being created by the human pollution, are eliminated out and then atmosphere catches it and returns it back in a form of an acid rain. But acid rains are natural also, and we have seen it. For example, volcanic eruptions are there, or lightning processes are there which can cause a natural acidification also, and it can also cause an alkalization, because of which minerals are washing away, they are removed away, and we are completely lagging behind with very good quantity of minerals which were present for nature, which is present with nature for the human being. One of the major factor which is creating a land degradation is called as a deforestation, or for that case, if you look forward, it will be also called as desertification. So you can find from this picture itself what do I mean by desertification. That means a land area which is completely relatively dry now, it has increased its aridity. That means it has completely lost the water body, it has completely lost the vegetation, it has completely lost wildlife, minerals. It has been converted into a land area of desert where human cannot survive. Now this land area which was fruitful, which was vegetative, converting into a desert area, that means we have created a pollution in it. And when we have created a pollution in it, it creates a patchy land area. That means the pollutant gets saturated not only above the surface, but in they enter inside the surfaces also, in deep inside the earth channels also. and where you can find the water pollutant takes place. Like we had seen in the water pollution, that if the pollutant enter into the water through the channel form, it will cause pollution because of the alkalinity. That means salt balance will be improper and you will have to drink or you will have to use something called as salty water. So that is called as desertification. Now I have said in the starting also that if there is a problem, there is a solution. So the solution is very simple. Do not go for deforestation. That means try to plant more and more plants. Try to limit up yourself to your own area. Try to control your domestic animals. Don't do overgrazing. Try to use much of organic material, for example, fertilizers, pesticides, insecticides. Rather than using these, you can go for something which is organic in material. Try to take agricultural cropland as per the criteria of nature itself. Not creating pollution, mining, etc., etc., some basic ideas. What we are going to talk something different today is something called as EFL. And this question was asked again and again in the competitive examinations also. So EFL means ecologically fragile land. Now what is mean by ecologically fragile land? Government takes a project. That means government identifies a land which is having a good growth of plants and animals which are ecologically different. That means these species are rare in itself. The animals which are found in this area are rare. They are very, very proper so that they cannot mix up with another kind of environment. Okay. This area, when the government identifies such a kind of plant and animal, rare animal and plant, they define it or they give a declaration, notification that this land will be called as ecologically fragile land. When the government does so, there becomes a compulsory rule that we cannot transfer ourselves. That means human society living in that particular area, around that particular area, will not be able to graze their domestic animals or live in that particular area. Also, one should keep in mind, when we talk something about ecologically fragile land, it may sometimes also include the tribal existence of human. So they can also live over there and they are identified as one of the rare human society. That means they do not have a direct contact with that of the society where we are living. They have a very different kind of contact. They have a very different kind of society. So for that case, if you want to go, you can just go back for some of the articles which are there mentioned regarding the tribal zones. So we can find the same tribal zones in India also, and these tribal zones are very active in especially South Africa. They have their own society, they have their own way of living, and they are being declared as living on ecologically fragile land. So basically these people, they worship nature. They do not have such any kind of another worshipping system because they consider nature as the god. And henceforth, it is completely illegal in that society to cut down the trees or kill the animals. So we have a different concept about urban people, we have a different concept about tribal people. But actually, tribalization or living a tribal life is something very living close to the nature. So that is called as ecologically fragile land. And ecological fragile land are under the control of government. Okay. So today in this lecture, we have seen something about the land resource. What are the uses of the land resource? So you should keep in mind these uses of the land resource with regards to 6 different kinds of soil which India is having and 3 different kinds of segmentation. Next one, we have seen something about the type of land resource, which is of course completely meant for the commercial use. That means developing the country with the help of whatever money we are getting from this kind of land resource. Next, we have seen something about the land degradation, how we are overutilizing the land and creating a hazard over there. One of the major part of degradation is desertification, which is increasing widely right now. And the solution, one of the best solution what government has given us, is called as EFL, that is called as ecologically fragile land. So I hope you people have understood this concept very clearly. If you have any problem, you can just go back and rewind it, or you can just mention it in comment section. Till the next lecture, study hard.